For me, there has always been something liberating about going to woods and making your own food. About using your tools and nature's resources to cook something and keep you going for another day. Just detach from society and forget about everyday problems. And today we make exactly that. Get yourself an axe, build a fire, and get ready to make some end of the month. Уха!
Yes, Boris!
January is soup month. This means here is your chance to shine by throwing things into a pot and calling it food. And this is basically what that is. Уха is a kind of fish soup, or technically more like a broth. Said to be one of the tastiest things in Russian cuisine, it is a very light meal that you can enjoy with other Slav food like чебурек. You see, the definition of a true уха is the soup that you make by the lake or the river that you caught the fish from. I do not suggest you get the water from river unless you want to have a stomach adventure of a lifetime. Step 1. Build fireplace of things you find. Step 2. Make some firewood, enough to last the whole cooking process. Step number minus 1. Catching the actual fish. This is not a tutorial for that, but a truly skilled Slav will just pull fish out of water with hand no problem. For making уха, freshwater fish is preferred. Sturgeon or bream or cod, whatever you get your hands on is fine. Step number 3. Gutting your fish. A true fisherman will gut his fish right on the spot with whatever tools he can find. If you find yourself with only an axe and a Kalashnikov bayonet, then you will make do with what you have. This part blurred out so people do not get nightmares. Cut off fish head and add into soup. It will give a very nice taste. Or if you prefer your food not to look at you when you eat it, just leave it for your neighbor's cats to enjoy. Clean out the unnecessary organs from inside, and here you have two options. You can just hack the fish up to 4 pieces and throw these big chunks into the soup. Or if you are looking for the visually more appealing version, then just flay the fish instead. Then you can enjoy a more relaxing уха experience without worrying about fish bones in your throat. Now, when you are making уха, make it from fresh fish. And not just that, I dare you to go outside and do it on open fire, блять. Throughout history, there have been many alterations to this recipe. But the one I'm making today is the most simple, or the most просто, that you can make. For you see, every component that you put inside is from the nature that is around you. Or бабушка's garden, you know, same thing. And this is why I call it the end of month recipe of soups. You make fire, you throw stuff inside, and boom, you have created something historically significant. Remember not to pay too much attention to the size of components. Once you cook this stuff for good 10 or 15 minutes on open campfire flame, ой, блин, it will not just be ready, it will taste like childhood memories. And remind you of the time that your father taught you how to fish. Step number 7. Once you have added a potato into the mix, cut up a carrot as well. Again, no need to be fancy with it. Bayonet surgery is not part of today's recipe. But cutting up components on wood stump will add flavor and slavness into recipe. Although originally уха was made with the least amount of vegetables inside, I encourage you to do it boy style. Add one onion into the mix. Precision cutting is optional, but not required. I just prefer to have it in big chunks. Let it deal rain from heavens to give your soup the Slav flavor you desire. Add comrade parsley into the party. And do not forget the green onion. Without which the soup would not be the same. Now cover everything with good clean drinking water so that everything is floating. Well, now that the easy part is over, set the soup to boil. Space up the flame if you need to. And the most important part of all, the bay leaf. And a whole 2 tablespoons of salt, блять, and a generous amount of ground black pepper. Show some love to the soup and gently mix in the flavor that you have put together with your own hands. And now you wait for about 15 minutes and feel free to fill your time with some vodka and семечки. What else better way to spend your time waiting for your food to cook in the forest? After about 15 minutes of cooking, it is time to check up on your soup.
Yes, very nicely cooking. This mix is optional, but very highly suggested. Chernobyl looks nice this time of year. Блять, potato still not done.
The give it another 5 to 10 minutes if you need. And remember, the soup is ready when the potatoes are ready. Grab yourself a bowl and enjoy. Add some more salt if you did not add enough. And some lemon on top, if you prefer it that way. But for me, I eat it exactly as I made it right now. Add some more dill for that finishing touch. And enjoy with a side of absolutely nothing. Блин, it is good. Leave the pot to sit on the fire some more if you are expecting guests, or just enjoy it later on with a side of чебурек. Well, thank you for watching, my friends. I hope you enjoyed. Please, try this at home if you have a river or a lake and a pot and some cinder blocks and fresh fish, potatoes, carrots, green onion, parsley, salt, pepper and a lot of slimy cinder blood. And of course, stay cheeky breaky, my friends. I will see you next time.